I love New Jersey, as you know. And my wife and I chose New Jersey. I grew up here, but I came back. Said, this is where we're going to be. And it's frustrating to me that there's always so much negative news out there about Jersey. And listen, we're going to continue to yell about taxes because we're going to get something changed. There is no question about it. But you need sensible leadership in Trenton. Now, one of the people that has been leading the charge in New Jersey to create jobs. How many times have I talked about creating jobs and empowering small business? Because when you do that, the tax revenues go up. You create the incentive to bring the businesses in, and then come with the businesses come the jobs, and with the jobs come the tax revenue. And that lowers the burden on the rest of us. So we need an economic spark in this state. I'm joined now by Lieutenant Governor Kim Guadagno. Lieutenant Governor, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Thanks for having me. It's a good news story today.
Yeah, I love good news. So give me some good New Jersey news.
Well, the good New Jersey news of the day is that New Jersey has beat the nation in terms of growth and jobs this past month. Who would have thought?
That's outstanding. All right, tell me, so how did that happen? that's huge.
It happens with a lot of work and a lot of time. I think in the last 6 years, I've visited thousands of companies inside of New Jersey and outside of New Jersey and asked them to stay in New Jersey, to grow in New Jersey. And I think now that the numbers are beginning to work for these companies and now that they're beginning to feel welcome in New Jersey again, they have faith that the future for their particular companies are here in New Jersey. And this unemployment rate just shows that objectively.
So we led the nation in, now this, we're talking about the private sector. We're talking about largely, I imagine, small businesses. I mean, I've had this conversation that the largest single employer in terms of a group are small businesses in New Jersey. What's the number one complaint you get when you talk to these small business leaders?
Taxes.
Yeah.
I mean, and you know that. The Tax Foundation came out this week that even though the governor of the state of New Jersey has vetoed taxes more than any other governor in the history of America,
yeah.
And even though we have cut business taxes $2.3 billion by the end of this year or next, we still are absolutely dead last in terms of business climate when it comes to taxes. So the common complaint for every company I speak to is taxes.
Let me ask you, last year you gave out your cell phone. Do you still do that?
Oh, my goodness. I give my cell phone number out to everybody. Now, I'm not going to do it on
your phone. No, I'm not asking. But you go to these events, you give out your cell phone. How many small business owners take you up on that and call you and reach out?
Thousands.
Yeah.
Thousands. And they're not just calling about, you know, their tax problems. They're talking about, why can't I get through to unemployment? Why can't I get through to the Economic Development Authority to find out what loans or grants might be available to me? I get phone calls day and night from small companies and large companies. My favorite example of a phone call is I gave a cell phone number out to the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce about 3 months after Sandy hit. Mm-hmm. And 2 weeks after that, a guy calls me on the phone and he says, I got your phone number at the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. I need one piece of paper in order to get a $150,000 SBA loan. So I can rebuild my company, not my company, my restaurant after Sandy hit.
Yeah.
And we were able to get him that one piece of paper, and now it's not only open in Highlands, New Jersey, with 10 or 20 employees, but he's opened another business.
That's great. That's great.